Spent 24 hours, I need more hours with you. You spent the weekend getting even, ooh. We spent the late nights making things right between us. But now it's all good, babe. Roll that backwood, babe, and play me close. Cause girls like you run around with guys like me till sundown. When I come through, I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah. Girls like you love fun and yeah, me do what I want. When I come through, I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I need a girl like you, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I need a girl like you. I spent last night on the last flight to you. I took a whole day up, trying to get way up. Ooh. We spent the daylight trying to make things right between us. And now it's all good, babe. Roll that backwood, babe. And let me blow.
One bag, so I literally have like five, eight, I don't know, too many. Right now, I'm taking alterations to my lady who does them. It's like literally so early in the morning, but this is the only time that she's there actually, and she leaves at 12 during the day, so it kind of worked out. Like that's pretty good for me because I can't come later, and I'll just go early before work, but good morning. Welcome back to my channel. My name is Gray. If you're new here, I am so happy to have you. It's Friday. Happy Friday. I'm gonna take you for a little weekend in my life. I've filmed week in my life recently, but not like weekends. And so we're gonna show you what I get up to this weekend. Should be fun. I have a lot planned. Should be hectic, but happy Friday. Let's do it. The reason I'm getting them altered right now and not waiting till the weekend is because I'm not gonna be here tomorrow, and I believe that they're closed on Sundays, or she's not here on Sundays. And one of the things that I'm getting altered is a top for Stagecoach, which is so exciting because it's literally in like 2 weeks and I can't wait. And the other are like little vintage slip dresses. They're so beautiful, but I just need to get them taken in a little bit. So we're gonna do that. I'm back in the car and I'm done with work. I look a lot less crazy right now than I did earlier in the video, I feel like, but I'm done with work. The week is over. another successful, amazing week. Super busy, super chaotic, but it was really good. And now I'm going to Katie's house. Katie is one of my best friends. If you guys haven't watched my channel before, she's been on like multiple videos, but obviously if you're new, then you wouldn't know that. But we're gonna go ride bikes from Huntington to Newport and maybe like have a little picnic, watch the sunset, have some dinner. It's gonna be really fun. And then I'll be at her house tonight. And then tomorrow I think we're just gonna tan. I'm gonna sleep there. And we're gonna go to corepower probably. I don't know, I brought like all my stuff for that. So that's exciting. And yeah, I'm just happy it's Friday. I'm happy to be done. But my day was pretty good. It felt a little bit long, but other than that, it was really good. And I liked my outfit today, so that's like always a positive when you like your outfit. But okay, that's what I'm gonna do. I'll show you guys when I get to Katie's, but you should see my car. I think I said this, but it literally looks like I'm moving into her house. It's ridiculous, but okay, love you, bye, see you there.
Hi, vlog.
I'm here, finally. I got her boots at Boot Barn. No, I didn't even open them yet. I went last night because I'm a good friend.
Okay, the box I don't want to open.
Because I love you too much.
Thank you. We'll show them inside.
Okay, but I'm here. Please look at this.
Oh, all your bags?
You guys, I'm literally going to be here for a day and a half. That's
remember,
it.
Remember when you made fun of me for bringing this big suitcase to your house?
I should have brought a suitcase.
I'm so excited. I'm out of breath. She'd be running all around her freaking house, you guys. She got me something for my baptism. I'm gonna show you, and she's, are you trying them on?
Yeah, should I not?
I think we're just gonna hold them up. She's gonna try them on
for
you.
No, we can show them. I just wanna make sure they fit.
Oh my God, this is so cute. Hold on. It says God is
love. I can't wait to wear these with a dress.
And it's gonna be so cute. It says God is love.
Do you have that one?
I have it in red, but I don't have it in gold.
I knew it.
No, this is perfect.
Oh my gosh.
She's... Because the red doesn't go with everything.
Oh, I know.
Those are so cute.
Do you want it?
Please.
This is what they look like, not one.
We love. We genuinely love them. Okay. And then she got me this. Oh my God. It's so cute. I should have brought...
Is it big enough?
Yeah, I should have brought sweats that I could like wear with this. She says his love endures forever. Yes, it does. That's so cute. Thank you.
I was gonna get you the one that said but God, but then I saw your mom wearing it.
I love that one too, so this one's perfect though. Thank you.
You're welcome.
We're gonna go ride bikes now. I think I can bring them, right?
Yeah.
I'm gonna bring you along if you're lucky. So happy to be done with work. Okay, bye. See you in a little. Here we go. You guys, I'm kind of scared. I've never done this, like, I've never ridden electric bikes. I'm not that good at riding bikes, anyways.
California sunshine. Funny how the years keep rolling. Some things never change.
If you know, you know.
I don't know.
This is Katie and Gigi's first time here, right? This is your first time too?
Do you like this song?
Bistro.
We rode all the way here. My hands are a little cold.
Same.
What else?
Now we're gonna go eat on the beach.
Eat on the beach.
Yeah.
Just happy to be here, honestly.
Who needs a boyfriend when you have us? I find my own cute dates.
I forgot to film
the jacuzzi. I just realized. I just showered. I'm in this little set. It's really cute. We're gonna watch Puss in Boots and then we're gonna go to bed because I think me and Katie are gonna go to corepower tomorrow morning. Yeah?
Yeah, let me see if I have clothes.
The verdict is still out. We're gonna hope and pray that she wants to go. Worst comes to worst, you can wear your black Lulu leggings that you wore tonight and a bra.
Yeah, I just need to find a sports bra.
And then we're gonna tan and swim and we're gonna hang out with our friends. You know, every time I think my skin is good, I just get humbled.
It's so cute.
She's posting. You wanna show?
My favorite picture of Gray.
Wait. And then me and my noodles. Are you doing a dump?
I'm just tonight.
Thank you.
And then I don't know which way it is. Me and TT.
Cute.
And then probably some takeout.
That was a good picture I took, huh?
Yeah.
I'm a photographer. It's whatever. I'm gonna do a little skincare routine right now. I think that's better. Oh my. Is this a joke? 1, 2, 3. There we go. I'm like dying. My hair feels dry. I don't know how to say it. I'm not even gonna try. It's my favorite. I also use it before I curl my hair or blow dry it as a heat protectant. We're gonna use it right now though, after the jacuzzi. I've been really liking La Roche-Posay. Is that how you say it? I don't know. This brand recently. I use the clarifying solution on a little pad every night and I wipe my face with it. I think it's like a toner. I don't know.
I'm very interested in this because you have amazing teeth.
What?
Yeah.
Come here.
She's watching my skincare routine.
I know, it's important. Huh. Do you still have the
Fabian
pull up on yourself?
No.
On
Safari? I always do.
I
got ears. It's literally like any makeup that's left from the night or like the day or whatever, it gets out and it's just so good. I love it. And then I washed my face with the gentle cleanser before this, and then I just do the Derma E. I use this like in the morning too. This is like my daily moisturizer for morning and night, and then I just do a little bit of that. Hold on. Okay, I do my moisturizer like that. I'm gonna rub it in, of course. I feel like when I eat a lot of sugar or I eat a lot of dairy or I am stressed, which I have been recently, I get acne more than like usual. And even when I'm not working out. But pimples are normal. They happen. It's okay. My skin's come a long way, honestly. I feel like. That's what I do. And then I also use, once I feel like my moisturizer is like really blended in, I use this from La Roche-Posay as well, called like Effa Claire Duo. I don't even know. Looks like this, like a little tube. Dual action acne treatment. That's what I use. And I just put it in every spot that I feel like I'm like struggling. My problem areas right now. And Always my underneath my like right here and my chin always has acne. Like that's I struggle there because I sit at work like this and like I touch my face and then your forehead, like if you sweat or whatever, which I've been working out a lot, if like working out a good amount, so my forehead and then like my cheeks right here. I'm definitely like a T-bone area type of gal, but yeah, that's the sitch. What I do, and if I have acne, like if I have a pimple and I pop it, I know this is like a very random opinion, but like this is random, but this is what I put on it. Good old Neosporin. I have always done this and it is like the best. I feel like it helps my skin the most. I don't know, that's just my opinion, and it gets rid of them. And yeah, that's what I feel like. I know that's unpopular opinion. Probably not a lot of people do that, but that's what I do. So that's my little skincare routine. I'm going to watch Puss in Boots and we're going to go to bed. TT, you want to say bye?
Bye.
Bye, good night.
This is what I'm talking about.
Yup.
Yup. Love. You ready, Pickles?
Pickles
it's
is ready.
So dark. Oh. Love you, bye.
Love you, bye.
Wanna rub my belly? what's happening? I need to practice. I'm gonna be a therapy dog someday.
Oh, I love about? Him.
I'm glad you asked. When people feel bad, they can rub my belly. It'll make them feel better. Rub my belly.
No. No. Let me be clear.
Stop that.
You guys, it's like eight in the morning. It feels like it's the middle of the night because it's so dark in here, genuinely.
It's so early.
Katie's mad at me that I'm dragging her to Corepower right now. The last night's remnants are still in the room. The freaking cookies, my water, just like it's a mess.
Katie passed out.
Yeah, Kate, I was like, I'm so tired. And Katie's like, you know, you should just go to bed. And I was like, you're so right. I literally closed my eyes and I was like, out. I was like, Katie, good night. Did you sleep good though?
Mm-hmm.
Me too. I needed that. It's cold in here.
It's soundproof in here, so it's so easy to sleep.
Well, it's sound. So if I was screaming, no one could hear me?
No.
Like, really?
I mean, like, we're safe, but yeah.
That's
what theaters are for.
Anyways, we're gonna go to Corepower. We are. I'm gonna make her go.
Yeah.
I'm trying to be fitty for Stagecoach.
I'm gonna do downward dog and just collapse and take a nap.
I was like, Katie, you can just drop me off.
Heck no.
She was like, no, that's so mean. I can't do that. I'm like, is it? I'm fine.
No, that would be rude.
Then we're gonna get coffee and we're gonna lay out by the pool.
Yeah.
Katie was like supposed to go do something with her friends tonight in San Diego. She's like, the chances of me doing that, I'm not doing it.
There's a 1% chance.
I'm gonna check her location. She's gonna be doing it.
No. I got a game to go to tomorrow.
Oh, she got a game. She got a game to go watch. You know, she needs her beauty sleep. Anyways, we're gonna get up right now and go.
Are we?
I was on 28%.
Charge it.
Okay, bye. See you at Corepower.
Kidding.
Dragged her here. Look at us go.
I'm grateful
we made
now.
It, right? I think it's gonna feel good afterwards.
I need to get a water.
Oh my god, I left my water in the car. The things that I make Katie do. Sorry.
I don't even know.
a little tough.
A little?
My face. Yeah. You guys. I don't know what it was, but that class was so hot. Normally it's like 98 degrees in there. I think it was like 110. Like, I'm not even kidding. I was just breathing in like heat and hot air, and I was dripping sweat. Me and Katie were, we looked like we were at a pool. Like, honestly, I kept looking at her. I was like, I'm dripping. And she was like, me too. But I'm glad we went. I'm glad I made her go. Because I really like needed to do that, and I feel better, but I feel a little dehydrated at the same time.
I love the turtles, but I do not like box water.
It tastes weird, right?
Yeah.
Katie was saying that they discontinued the, what is it, the raspberry syrup?
Yeah, at Starbucks.
At Starbucks.
I gotta figure out a new drink.
I think you should try the strawberry puree.
Okay.
We're gonna get Starbucks, and then we're gonna go get our nails done, and then we're gonna go lay out by the pool and tan and have ourselves a day. But we're done with core. Had to update.
It's my fault.
Love you, bye.
Oh wow, that's a good little setup.
Remember when we were driving to LA and it was like,
yeah.
You guys, I'm gonna vlog Stagecoach. It's in 2 weeks. I think I've said that 5 times this video, but me and Katie are going together. So I'm gonna vlog that. We're gonna be a hoot. We're gonna be a mess, but it's fine. I'm so excited. What about you?
I am thrilled to be going. Especially I just don't know. I'm not that excited yet because I don't have my outfits picked out. Once I have my outfits picked out, then I'll be more excited.
So valid. She's so funny. I keep telling her what to wear.
One outfit.
Like, I've been telling her, do this. And she's like, yeah, I just don't know. I'm like, I'm literally telling you, wear this.
That's, yeah.
I need to see that. Is the skirt in San Diego?
The skirt's really cute.
The sequin one?
Oh, no, it's in this picture. Okay, you have to ignore my outfit because I have my boot on halfway. And I tried it on with the little bandeau top. So it looks really terrible. It's like a sparkly skirt.
I can envision. Is it like sequins or is it just sparkles?
No, and I had this hat on with it.
Oh, that's so cute.
But I had my red boot on halfway, so I look a little special in that.
I like that, but I don't think you should wear those red boots.
No, I agree.
You should wear your black ones.
But I don't want to wear that. That was a bodysuit that I like rolled up, so it looked a little weird.
Just wear like...
Is it this?
A little teeny tiny top.
Well, I have this one saved on Revolve. Your mom's gonna see this vlog and be like, you're not driving with her, she's not safe, she's on her phone.
Oh my god.
I kid.
Please. Come on. Your mom. My mom, shout out my mom for watching my vlogs.
Hi.
Everyone.
I miss you. Hi mom.
Hi mom. My parents are going to the spring game at USC today.
Oh, I got asked.
Oh, that's so cute.
Do you think that top would look cute with it?
Yeah, do that one. Yes. Yes, there you go. One outfit done.
Oh, but look, it's pre-order. Oh, expected to be in stock on the 30th.
Of what? April?
March.
Oh.
That's like... the 9th. Well, that's awkward.
No, it's the 15th.
No, I'm saying like, it says to the 9th. I think this would be not cute because I think it's not the right material.
Yeah.
Don't honk at me. It just turned green. Just kidding. Jesus loves you.
Jesus loves you. It's fine. It's fine. Katie, we were riding bikes yesterday, and this guy, like, there's like designated bike lanes when you ride at the beach because like everyone rides bikes. So obviously, me, Katie, and TT are in the bike lane driving. This man is legitimately driving like in the bike lane, and Katie was like right next to a garage, so like she had like this much room to get by his car and like to the garage. So he was like really gonna hit her. I thought he was gonna run her over. And I think his wife was like yelling at him in the car.
Out.
She was stressed. But Katie like went like this, like, and put her hand up. But I only saw this side, and I thought it was her middle finger. And I was like, Catherine Gath, put that middle finger down. She's like, I didn't even put it up.
The man ended up being really old, and I felt very bad.
Yeah. I'm like, Jesus loves you.
I'm like,
okay, bye. We're gonna go do some nails.
Do some nails.
Vlog you, and I mean, I'll vlog when we get our starbs. Bye.
back so soon. You guys.
That smells really good.
I know. I was like, what is that? It smells really good. Honestly, like, why do people just sometimes really struggle with simple tasks? I don't know. I was like, I got a coffee. What was I even gonna ask for? Oh, when I paid, I was like, will you please use my rewards if I have any? He's like, yeah, sure. Gives me my phone back. He's like, I didn't use any rewards, I forgot. I was like, okay. And then the girl brings her drink out and she's like, is this what you wanted, like, in your drink? And I was like, sure, like, whatever. And then yanks the lid off. I was like, okay, it's one of those mornings. This is what we got, though. And this. Cheers. That's my toxic trait. Mm. I can never just get one drink.
I know.
It's like literally my toxic trait. I'm like putting Katie on to my toxicity. I went to In-N-Out and Boba when we were going to Palm Springs.
Oh, yeah.
We had to get Diet Coke, and then we had to get Boba. And we had to get not only one, but two bobas. Like, Katie got a boba, I got a boba.
You got three.
And then we got one to share. That's what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, it's awful. Anyways. Hot. Hot, hot, hot. Okay, bye.
Like, awesome.
These are the nails, you guys.
Nubby nails.
Nubby nail gang. I cut all mine off. Yeah. Go. Oh my god. Oh my god.
Then you have to go off of that.
Off what?
Above the slide.
Oh yeah.
This is my bathing suit for the day. It's really cute. I'm wearing shoes because we're playing pickleball, but it's my bathing suit.
Somewhere where the summer lasted all year round. Probably got a big old diamond on your hand right now. Maybe a baby or a couple by now. Long driveway to a big white house. But I wonder when you're drinking, if you find yourself thinking about that boy from East Tennessee. And I know we both knew better, but we still said forever, and that was 7 summers of cool and southern comfort. Were we dumb or just younger? Who knows? Back then you used to love the river.
Why do I need 80,000 drinks? I don't know. My coffee from earlier, my Gatorade, my water, my ice, and more water. Like, why do I need that? I don't know. My stuff's everywhere. And I'm so tired, but it was a fun day. I'm gonna pack up my stuff and go home. So sad, Pickles.
So sad.
Hi, guys. I look freaking crazy, and I need chapstick so badly. Hello. Maybe I don't have any in here, whatever. I left Katie's a little while ago. There's people watching me. I drove home and then I picked up a salad because I'm kind of hungry, so I got that. And then I need to get gas on the way home right now. And then when I get home, I have so much stuff to put away. It's actually ridiculous the amount of stuff that I have in my car right now. And all I wanna do is lay in my bed and watch a movie and then go to bed, but I have to put all my stuff away and then I have to get my stuff ready tomorrow because I have to go to church so early and I'll be there like the whole morning, which is fun, but it's just a lot and I know I'm gonna be tired. So yeah, that's what I have to go do at home right now, even though I just wanna go sleep. But it's such a good day. It was really freaking fun. I like love days like yesterday and today, and it just made me really happy. And that's always good after like a long work week. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, bye. Okay, I'm going to bed. It's 10:45, way later than I should have went to bed in the first place. I'm literally knocking out. Good night. The set is so cute also. I love it. I'm going to church so early tomorrow morning, so we're gonna go to bed and get our beauty sleep for that, but good night. Good morning, beautiful people. Happy Sunday. I'm going to church right now, 7:45 in the morning. It's a little earlier than my normal time for church, to be honest, but oy. But I'm pretty used to waking up early for work. However, it's still not that fun because I feel like I don't get that much sleep during the week. And so on my weekends, I like really try to get like 8.5 plus and not wake up that early. I try to like cut the line at 8 a.m. Like that's the earliest I'll wake up on the weekends. But you know, today I had to wake up at 6:45. So that's fine, it's okay. You know, anything for the church, I'm happy to go, happy to do it. I get to like see all my friends today, which is really fun because as you guys know, if you've watched my vlogs before, I'm in a life group and I meet with them every Tuesday, which is so fun. But some of them work like on the weekends and stuff. So sometimes we like don't see each other at church, but today I think there's like a lot of people gonna like be at that service, and so it'll be really fun because I love them and I love seeing them like on multiple days of my week. It makes me happy, especially at church. Anytime my friends are at church, I am ecstatic, over the moon happy, because like what is better than all the people you love at church, being with God, worshiping together? I can't name something. So yeah, I kind of have a busy day. I feel like I try to not plan so much in my day and then I end up planning a lot in my day. I'm gonna go to this service. It's like for a serve thing. So I'm going to this service first for the serve thing and then afterwards to the normal service. And then I will go home, I will change. I will go to corepower, come home, shower, change, go to lunch with my parents, like a late lunch, whatever. And then I will go home, clean my room, get my outfits out for the week and like everything that I need for tomorrow. And then I might try to film another video today, just like life updates and a makeup routine, because a lot of people have been asking me. So I might do that if I have time. And there was something else I had to do, but yeah. And I think me and my mom are gonna start going to yoga classes like in the morning before I go to work, like super early, like 5:30. And yoga classes, I mean not in like corepower yoga workouts, like an actual yoga flow without like the weights and the cardio and all that. And so that will be nice, but you know, that's really early. So I'm gonna try to go to bed earlier tonight. So yeah, that's my little update. I just talked for 3 minutes, sorry. Anyways, happy Sunday, beautiful people. Jesus loves you. I love you. See you at church. You guys, Jesus is gonna do it for me every single time. He really is. That service was actually unreal. So good. I like had tears in my eyes the whole service. And they gave us these books because we started a new series. And it says, I Need a Miracle, a look at what the miracles of Jesus mean for you. And we basically walked well, we talked through Matthew today and the four miracles that he performed. I'll read it too because I'm waiting for this line to go forward. Matthew 9, 18, verse 34 has one of my favorite passages ever. And he was telling, it says, and he was telling them these things. Suddenly, one of the leaders came down and knelt before him, saying, "My daughter just died, but come lay your hand on her and she will live." So Jesus and his disciples got up and followed him. Just then, a woman who had suffered from bleeding for 12 years approached from behind and touched the end of his robe. For she said to herself, "If I can just touch his robe, I'll be made well." Jesus turned to her and saw her. "Have courage, daughter," he said. "Your faith has saved you." And the woman was made well from that moment. Genuinely, that's like one of my favorite passages ever in the entire Bible. And there's three other miracles that Jesus performs in chapter 19 in Matthew. And so we walked... I cannot speak right now. We talked through those other miracles as well, but that's always been one of my... I'm gonna sneeze. Oh my gosh, I'm just a mess right now. Okay, anyways, goodness gracious. That miracle with the girl in Matthew that I just read to you is one of my favorite verses because I love how she knows so deeply in her heart that she has been suffering for 12 years and she has been deemed unclean for 12 years because she was bleeding, and at that time that meant you were unclean and you couldn't touch other people. And she reached out and touched Jesus's robe. She just knew if she could just touch his robe, not even touch him, touch his robe, that she would be healed, because she knew the power that he had. She had so much faith in who Jesus was and what he was capable of. And I just think that's such a desirable way to live your life, is to know so deeply in your heart, if we could just get a touch of Jesus, we would be healed. Nothing else in this entire world can compare to what Jesus does, who he is, and how much he can heal us. And she didn't make him unclean by reaching out and touching him. He cleaned her. He purified her because he is so perfect. He is so pure. He is so clean. He changed her. And that's what happens when we reach out and when we touch Jesus and he heals us. He makes us clean. He makes us pure. He makes us beautiful again. And like, that was just making me really emotional. And it's always been one of my favorite passages. The worship was so good. And I think it's just special to have like busy weeks or busy weekends and just come to church on Sundays and be with Jesus and spend your time in his house with his people and just like feel his love and his mercy and grace poured out on you through that. And the serving was really good also. And so I'm just leaving church feeling really good and just really content and just grateful for who Jesus is and what he means to me and what he has done in my life and all the miracles that he has performed for me. I just had to go on a little rampage and share that with you. And just let you know that if you're searching for a miracle or you need healing or anything, turn to Jesus and have faith that he is good and that he can heal you. He can make a miracle happen in your life if he chooses to. And if he doesn't, he's still good. And I just thought that you guys should hear that and know that. But I'm gonna go home and then literally rush and change and get ready for corepower and go have a corepower class. But yeah, that was my morning. Okay, love you, bye. Look at how fast that turnaround time is. Period, I literally was like 10 minutes in and out. Hold on to music. You guys, I haven't eaten all day. It's 12:30. Been up since, I don't even know what time I was up. 6:45, yeah. And I had an entire large, huge coffee. No food. So I'm literally eating this little chunk thing. My parents went to Costco and got these at Costco, and I'm obsessed with them. They're like oatmeal chocolate chunk. That's the best I can explain it. And I'm just gonna eat this because I feel like if I eat anything more, I'm gonna throw up at the class. And then after, I'm gonna go to lunch with like one of my friends. So Cheers. Are you tired of seeing me in the car? Because I'm tired of it too. See you after Core Power. Hopefully I make it in time. I also have no gas because I didn't get it last night. So that's fun.
Say hi to the vlog.
Hi.
As we're dead. Felt really good though. My hair looks crazy. This is her second time. I brought her.
Dripping sweat.
She did good. I brought her on Monday and she was like, this is hard. And I was like, yes, you're coming back with me. And here she is. So this is a testament. It's good, but it doesn't kill you that bad. It's okay.
Don't mind me. You guys, that's how much my body's shaking right now from that class. Happy Sunday. I really like want to get super toned and like cut down right now. And so I'm gonna try to work out like every single day because I really wanna like lean out my muscles and get super toned. So we're gonna be going to Core Power more, but I'm not gonna lie and tell you that my body doesn't hurt. I'm gonna go home and then shower really fast, change, and then I'm gonna meet Bella for food. I also like literally have no gas, so after that I'm gonna get gas. Hey, love you.
I literally showered and changed in 10 minutes, taking my trash out, going to the gas station to get gas and to get a wax job on my car, and then me and Bella are going to lunch and I'll pick my car up afterwards. But this is the little fit. I came to Earth in raining. Oh, it's so dark.
Oh, I know. Oh, is light better? I feel like it's better facing this way. Oh, yeah. You got salad. I'm starving. I have chicken pesto. On the way out. Every single time. I'll show you when we get around.
You guys, the most horrifying thing in the world, no, not actually, but genuinely something so horrible happened. So I was gonna show you the food and then I almost threw up, so I didn't, but we get the food, whatever. I take my picture because I'm annoying, and I literally, like, I'm about to put my fork into the salad and I was like, why is that little piece a different color than the rest? There was a bug in the salad. I'm gonna insert the picture. Ready? One, two, three. You guys, pause it and zoom in because I literally like was shocked. I had my mouth open on the, like literally like this for like 2 minutes, and then I almost threw up. Yeah, dry heaving because it was disgusting. I almost ate that fat bug. It was like a cockroach, I think.
So yeah, it looked like a cockroach, like a man.
Yeah, so I literally can't, hold on. I took the plate up to the guy. I think I'm gonna gag. I can't do it. I took the plate up to the guy to go tell him, and I was like, I can't tell this story without, I think I'm gonna throw up. I took the plate and I was like, and he was like, oh, and I was like, there's a bug in my food. I think I'm gonna puke. And then he was like, oh my God, that's disgusting. And I was like, right? And he's like, we've been having issues.
This is so bad. Issues with the lettuce, like their lettuce produce. So
I can't even handle you guys. They've been having issues with their lettuce. And he was like, do you want like something else? And I was like, I don't even know what to get. He's like, we can give you a sandwich, but the sandwiches have lettuce. We can do a pizza, but I don't need cheese. He's like, we can do a tostada, but tostadas have lettuce. I was like, oh my God, you know what? Just give me soup. Just give me soup and chicken. I'll just do soup and chicken. Cause there, hopefully there's no bugs in your soup or bugs in your chicken. But yeah, I almost ate that fat ass bug. And Bella caught a salad. She was like,
I was digging through the whole thing. I'm like, I need an extra plate. Just like,
ugh.
Yeah.
Anyways, that's what happened.
If I get sick from that salad, I swear to God.
No, hopefully you don't.
That's like, I don't know, I'm scared for you.
Yeah, my mom's like,
it's like her signature dish. Yeah, like every time we go to Earth, that's what she gets. Yeah, so.
I think honestly, it may have ruined it for me. Like, I don't know how I could ever eat that again without being like traumatized. I literally ate it last night. Maybe there was a bug in there last night. I genuinely ate it last night. I just remembered that. Oh my God, what if I ate a bug last night? Well,
I think it was like a one-off. Like, I feel like that obviously doesn't happen. Maybe we just don't go to that location.
I don't know. Seriously, I don't know.
Let's take a trip to Laguna.
The guy was like so apologetic and like refund my entire thing, but it was still disgusting.
What are those little like things he gave you?
Oh, he gave me like coupons for coffee, which was nice, but yeah. My camera's about to die. Anyways, I'm gonna go pick up my car and then go home. That's what happened. Look at how pretty she is. So nice and clean. I could literally eat off of it. That's how clean it is. Love her. Okay, you guys, I am going to film a updated makeup routine and also like what's been going on in my life recently, like updates and just talking about everything because I haven't done that in so long. So that's what I'm about to do now. So make sure you stay on the lookout for that. But I'm gonna end this video off here because it's Sunday night. I got all my outfits ready for the week and I've been like just preparing and getting everything together. So this is the end of my weekend vlog and I'm so grateful for you guys watching. I'm gonna try to film more. I know I keep saying that, but I really am gonna. And yeah, thank you guys for supporting me. I'm so grateful and I love each and every one of you so much. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. And my social media platforms are always linked down below, so you can go follow me on there too if you want. But I love you guys. Hope you enjoyed the vlog. See you in the next one.